Navigated Brain Stimulation, NBS, is a new technique for accurate, non-invasive mapping of the motor cortex. Combining TMS, transcranial magnetic stimulation, with navigation, NBS makes TMS visible in the brain. NBS mapping prior to surgery is as accurate as direct cortical stimulation, the gold standard. By offering physiological data as seeding points, NBS also facilitates tractography. Information on the functional areas and fiber tracts close to a brain lesion significantly helps in treatment selection and can help confirm surgery in challenging cases. Used for determining the need for interoperative monitoring and optimizing surgical access, NBS mapping results improve patient safety and save valuable time in the operating room. NBS mapping and tractography help maximize tumor resection while preserving quality of life for the patient. Looking to the future, navigated brain stimulation also has the potential to revolutionize TMS therapy by enabling the accurate targeting of neuromodulation for the first time.
We are using the system now for the last 3 years, and it became evident quite soon that it has dramatically changed the way how we approach the tumors before surgery, the intellectual workup and the decision making how to operate the tumor, and to decide how aggressive we can be on the individual tumor and on the individual patient. So now, 3 years since we have started to use it on a routine basis, I can really say that it has become an integral part of our pre-surgical workup, and it helps us tremendously.
A 45-year-old male presented with paresis of the right arm and leg. Imaging workup revealed a tumor in the central region of the left hemisphere. To reveal how close the tumor was to the motor cortex, mapping with navigated brain stimulation was performed. Using a standard head MRI dataset, the NBS system compiles a three-dimensional rendering. For alignment with the head, the nation and pre-auricular points on the rendering are selected as landmarks. TMS over the motor cortex evokes responses in the peripheral nerves. The motor evoked potentials are measured by placing EMG electrodes over the muscles. An infrared-based tracking system is used for navigation. The head tracker, the TMS coil, and the digitizer pen are all identified by reflecting marker spheres. For aligning the patient head with the rendering, the nation and preauricular points and 9 additional landmarks are recorded. With the location of the head determined by the head tracker, the position of the coil relative to the head is always known precisely. The head rendering is peeled to display the cortical anatomy. Triggering the TMS coil will induce a stimulating electric field, E field, in the underlying cortex. As the TMS coil is moved, the NBS system displays, in real time, the amplitude and direction of the E field, calculated for the individual patient. a sequence of stimuli is given to find the cortical representation area for the hand muscle abductor pollicis brevis, APB. Having the E-field visualized in the rendering allows fine control of TMS orientation and angle when moving the coil. A foot switch is used to trigger the TMS coil and deliver a stimulus. The evoked response in the APB muscle is automatically detected and displayed on the APB EMG channel. The evoked responses to all the stimuli are shown in the rendering as a heat map. The stimulation which generated the strongest EMG response from the APB muscle determines the optimal coil location, orientation, and tilt for motor threshold finding. The NBS system uses an automated motor threshold finding algorithm, giving stimuli at various intensities. The NBS system delivers the stimuli only when the TMS coil is precisely over the target and at the selected orientation. The stimulator output is automatically increased or decreased according to the EMG response. After multiple stimuli, the patient's individual motor threshold is calculated. For this patient, it is 31% of the stimulator output. For mapping the hand area, the stimulator output is set to 110% of the patient's motor threshold. Stimuli are given around and within the tumor with 2 to 5 millimeter spacing. The area stimulated is expanded until evoked responses are no longer detected. The result is a clear map of the representation areas of the hand muscles in the motor cortex. The results are explained to the patient, and the implications for treatment are discussed. The NBS mapping results are exported to the surgical planning software. For fiber tracking, the NBS results give a reliable physiological basis for selecting the seeding points.
So here we have a case of a 45-year-old male with a tumor of the left central region. As you can see here in the image, the tumor is outlined in red. The patient presented with a paresis of his right arm and leg. And first thing was that we performed the MRI scan for the navigational data set, and we then performed the mapping of the motor cortex with the Nexstim system. And the result can be seen here. The yellow spots here just on top of the tumor, on top and a little bit in front of it, they represent the spots where the stimulation with the transcranial magnetic stimulation evoked responses in his muscles. So this is the primary motor cortex of this patient. What we did then is we transferred the data to the planning station and we performed a DTI fiber tracking. And what we did is we identified the spot which evoked the biggest MEP, and that was the green spot which we can see here. We defined that as the hotspot of the primary motor cortex, and we told the software with just a few clicks to take this spot and perform an anterograde fiber tracking. And the result can be seen here. This is a fiber tract originating from this hotspot of the motor representation, and as you can see, it goes along right in front of the tumor. There's contact between the upper part of the tumor and the pyramidal tract, and then down here at the base of the tumor there's a little bit of distance. So we figure that we should approach that tumor from the dorsal aspect going in from here. We have to be very careful at the frontal aspect of the tumor, and we will perform subcortical direct stimulation there, guided by the results of the functional mapping.